Now let's look at the situation where our two primary variables of interest are continuous variables, and we would like to explore relationship between the two while we can add further categorical variables as additional dimension. Using the teaching evaluation data, we ask this question: does age affect teaching evaluations? And we add two additional dimensions, which are gender and tenure. So our data set consists of age and tenure. These are the two primary variables of interest that happen to be continuous. And we add two dimensions, i.e. gender and tenure, and these are the two categorical variables. So age is on the x-axis, and teaching evaluation score is on the y-axis, and the green color circles represent males, and the blue color circles represent females. The bottom panel is for tenured professors, and the top panel is for untenured instructors. Just by looking at the graphic, we cannot make out any trend, so we need to add additional details. Here you see that I have removed the tenure dimensions and have kept the gender dimension. The bottom panel is male, the top panel is female. I've changed the circles from hollow circles to filled circles, gray-colored filled circles. And more importantly, I have added lowest lines, which are sort of regression type lines, to see that for female instructors, we see sort of a downward sloping curve of teaching evaluations as age increases. But we don't see the same declining trend for males. It's sort of a rising trend with age, then it sort of levels off, and then eventually it declines. In this particular graphic, we have the same type of information, but we have changed the age variable from being a continuous variable to an ordinal type of variable, where age is now in different brackets, less than 28 years of age, 29 to 39 years of age, 40 to 51, 52 to 62, and 63 plus. In addition, the color of the circles is not representing males or females, but in fact it is representing two different variables. The blue color is the average teaching evaluation by age, and the green color circles are the normalized beauty score. You could see that the normalized beauty score appear to decline with age, and the teaching evaluations do not have the same downward sloping impression here. Since we did not have any instructors under the age of 28, we have a redundant category in the graphic. If we were to be using scripts, which is an option available with SPSS, we can actually remove the first category, which I have done here, and redrawn the same graphic. And now you see here that the less than 28 years of age category has been removed from the graph, and there is no redundant information in the graphic. In SPSS, we click on Graphs, Chart Builder, and select Scatter, Second Template, draw it to the canvas, and now we will populate this template. We put the age on the x-axis, teaching evaluation score on the y-axis, the coloring is set by gender, and we add the additional dimension of tenure to the panel and click OK, and here's the resulting graphic. To add the regression line, we double click on the chart and then click on regression line and pick lowest option and deselect attach label to line and click on apply and close the editor, and we have the lines drawn. We can change the color by double clicking on the line. To remove tenure, we go back to Chart Builder dialog and remove the row and panel variable and remove the grouping stacking variable and instead select the gender as the panel and click OK. And now we double click on it to edit this graphic. We select first the circles and click on fill and select gray color, and for border a darker shade of gray, say apply, and then click on regression line, click on lowest, deselect attach label to line, click apply. To change the color of the line, we double click on line and select color and select a different color, say apply, close the dialog box, and here's the scatter plot between age of the instructor and teaching evaluations with a regression type line fit to it. Now let us try to generate average teaching evaluation and normalized beauty score in the same graphic. And instead of using a continuous age variable, we will use a categorical variable for age. So we click on chart builder and we click on scatter.plot. And this is the rightmost option, which is summary point plot data that we want. So we drag it up there. And on the x-axis, we will put the variable age, which is binned. It is in different ages binned into different categories. And we now select the two continuous variables being the normalized beauty score and the teaching evaluation score and drag them to the y-axis. And we get this notice from SPSS and we just say OK. And it's pretty much it. We click OK and the output should appear. Notice this redundant category at the end, which you can remove using the script option.